In this video, we are going to discuss the asexual reproduction. In last class, we have studied about binary fission. What is binary fission? Bi means two, fission means two daughter. Fission means dividing. Bi means two, fission means divide. So a single parent organism will divide into two equal size. So this is called what? Binary fission. For example, so this is amoeba. This amoeba will divide in any plan into two daughter cells, two daughter amoeba. So it gives two daughter cells. So one parent cell, one parent amoeba gives or divides into two daughter cells. It's called binary fission. Today in this video, we are going to discuss the multiple fission. We know the meaning. Multiple means many. So here what happens? One parent cell will divide into many daughter cells. Like this. So if one cell divide into two, that is binary fission. When one parent cell, parent organism, divide into many daughter cells. Many daughter cells, like this. It divides into multiple divisions. So it is called what? Multiple fission. Simply you can say in binary fission only two daughter cells, whereas in multiple fission more than two. That is a significant characteristic of a multiple fission. What happens in this multiple fission? Various steps are there. First, what happens? What is the multiple fission? We will see the definition here. Parents body divide into similar daughter cells. Parents body, for example, this is parent body, divide into similar daughter cells more than two. That is called what? Multiple fission. But what are the steps going on? What happens in the multiple fission? First nucleus will divide. First step in multiple fission, nucleus will divide into several species. So for example, nucleus will divide. So this is a parent cell. So first what happens? Nucleus will divide. So first nucleus divide repeatedly, continuously. Nucleus alone will divide, but there is no division of cytoplasm takes place at the time of nucleus division. This is the difference. So first, what is the first stage? The nucleus of the parent cell will divide repeatedly, so it produces many nucleae. So this is many nucleae. So in that, at that time what happens? No cytoplasm division. No cytoplasm division occurs. Only the division occurs in the nucleus. So nucleus becomes several pieces. Next stage, what happens? After the completion of nucleus division, see the difference. After the completion of nucleus division, the cytoplasm will start divides. So this cytoplasm, will divide. This is cytoplasm. Once again, multiple fissions, a parent body gives many daughter cells. It divides into many daughter cells. Whereas in binary fission, only two daughter cells. This is the difference between these two. So in multiple fission, the first step is nuclear division. That is called karyokinesis. Nuclear alone will divide into several species. Continuously, repeatedly divide. At the time of nuclear division, there is no cytoplasm division occurs. This is different. Once complete nuclear division occurs, completed, then cytoplasm starts to divide. So this cytoplasm, each cytoplasm for one nucleus. So it surrounds the nucleus. It surrounds the nucleus. So this is nucleus. For example, this is nucleus. Cytoplasm will surround. So for each nucleus. Now, second step, cytoplasm divide into as many parts of nucleus. For example, 10 nuclei is there now, means 10 cytoplasm will divide. Not more than 10. This is the most significant character. Again, I will tell him. Second step, cytoplasm divides into as many parts as nucleus. So the young one do not separate until the process is completed. So first nuclear division will take place. Second, cytoplasm division takes place. So till that cytoplasm division occurs, there is no separation of young ones. Notice called what? Repeated fission. 2-mark question. What is repeated fission? The young one do not separate until the process is complete. For example, in plasmodium, how the multiple fission occurs. You know, plasmodium has a life cycle. Asexual reproduction also there, sexual reproduction also there. Whereas asexual reproduction takes place in man. We know very well about this life cycle of plasmodium, which causes malaria. So, in plasmodium, how the multiple fission occurs? In two types. So, in plasmodium, multiple fission occurs in two types. One is, it's called schizogony, and one more type is called sporogony. Why it is called schizogony? It occurs in schizont stage. It occurs in, this process of multiple fission occurs in the stage of schizont. So it is called what? Schizogony. So this multiple fission occurs in the schizont stage of life cycle of plasmodium. It results in merozoites. What is the sporogony? Sporogony is a process. In the sporogony process, it occurs in oocyte. It occurs in oocyte stage of plasmodium. So we know that oocyte, schizont, merozoite, cryptomerozoite, various stages occurs in life cycle of plasmodium. But in this stage, which stage? In oocyte stage, the multiple fission occurs, which produce more sporozoites. So in plasmodium, multiple fission occurs in two types. One is called schizogony, one is called sporogony. What is schizogony? Nothing but it occurs in schizont stage. Multiple fission occurs in this stage. What is the result? What are the daughter cells? This is called merozoites. It's called what? Merozoite. So merozoites are produced by a process called schizogony. This is the question. So what is schizogony? This is the question. What is the answer? Multiple fission occurs in schizont stage, gives rise to merozoites. This is called what? Schizogony. Whereas what is sporogony? It occurs in oocyte. Oocyte is a stage of plasmodium. In the oocyte stage, the multiple fission occurs. It divides into many pieces, many daughter cells. That is called what? Sporozoite. So these are the two types which occurs in plasmodium. Next, we will see the multiple fission in amoeba. What happens in amoeba? How the multiple fission occurs in amoeba? We will discuss. So now we will see the multiple fission in amoeba. In amoeba, what happens? Sometimes food will not available. Sometimes temperature may be increase or decrease. That is called unfavorable condition. So during unfavorable condition, the multiple fission occurs in amoeba in several steps. So now we are going to see about during unfavorable condition. So what? During unfavorable condition. What is mean by unfavorable condition? Nothing but the scarcity of food. Food is not available. Plenty of food will not available. At the same time, temperature may be high or may be very low. So during this condition, what happens? Amoeba first withdraws its pseudopodia. We know that this is an amoeba nucleus. This is pseudopodia. So it withdraws its pseudopodia. This is the first step. Withdrawal of pseudopodia will occurs when during unfavorable condition. This is the first step. Now what happens after withdrawal of parapodia? This amoeba secretes three layer. See here, 1, 1, 2, 3. This is three layers. It secretes three layers. It is a protective layer and also made up of chitinous substance. It is a chitinous protective. Three layers will form. This formation of three layers surrounds the amoeba. This process is called what? Encysement. So what is encysement? During unfavorable condition, amoeba loses or withdraws its pseudopodia and produces three chitinous protective layer. So it becomes inactive. This is more important. It becomes inactive. This inactive stage of amoeba surrounds by three layer, chitinous layer gives protection. This condition is called what? This process is called encysement. So this is the changes occurs during unfavorable condition. Once again the favorable condition returns, what happens during favorable conditions? It is the inactive amoeba become inactive. They divide inside the encyst by multiple fission. So here, this is nucleus, this is cytoplasm, three layers are there. This is called cyst wall. It happens, it is an inactive stage. This inactive stage, when the favorable conditions again will reoccur, what happens? The nucleus will divide. So during favorable conditions, divide by multiple fission, produce inside small pseudopodiospore. This structure, this is called small pseudopodiospore. Otherwise you can say amoebulae. This amoebulae formation, now amoebulae nothing but pseudopodiospore. As a result of continuous multiple fission occurs in the nucleus during favorable conditions. Now this amoebulae, these structures are called amoebulae. So what happens? The cyst wall absorbs water. Which absorbs water? The cyst wall absorbs water. This absorption of water, what happens? The cyst wall become break. The new pseudopodes, pseudopodiospore or amoebulae will release or liberate from the amoeba. So this is the process. So once again, in amoeba, during unfavorable condition, that means the scarcity of food may be occurred, or sometimes temperature may increase or decrease. During this condition, what happens? This amoeba withdraws pseudopodia, first step. The pseudopodias are there, which help for locomotion. This pseudopodia will withdrawn, so they become a circle shape, and this amoeba produce a cyst wall, three layered wall, which gives protection, and also it helps, it forms called cyst wall. This process is called what? Encysement. This is called what? Encysement. So again, it is made up of chitinous substance. Here, three layers will form. So these three layers will form. During favorable condition, what happens? The nucleus will divide. Into small pieces. Now this becomes as pseudopodiospore or amoebulae. So this what happens after that? The cyst wall absorbs the water. Because of the absorption of water, the cyst wall will break down. The inside the amoeba, inside the amoebulae, they liberated. They are released from the amoeba. They become a new life. They start their new life. They run their own life. Okay. So this is the process takes place in the amoeba during unfavorable condition by multiple fissions.